Hello everyone, my name is Ganesh Mereskar. So today we are going to discuss about the hydrology. So hydrology is nothing but the science which deals with the occurrence of water, its movement and its distribution. So today we are going to discuss specifically about the hydrological cycle. So before we begin this session, we will start our session with some questions. First question is, why do clothes dry faster in summer than winter? And another question is, how can fish survive in frozen lake? Okay, let's try to find out the answer. So we know that solid is made up of several molecules which are closely packed with each other. Okay, so within these two molecules there is a force of attraction. Okay, intermolecular force of attraction. So what happens when we apply heat? These molecules try to vibrate. Okay. Hence, density decreases. Then solids are converted into liquids. Okay. So in liquids, again, molecules are having some spacing and which are able to move slightly, vibrate slightly. Again, if you add the heat to liquids, these molecules will try to separate by increasing the spacing between these two molecules. Here, less density than solids. And in liquids, they have the smallest or less density than liquid. This process is reversible. So when we apply heat, solid will be converted into liquids. When we apply heat to liquids, liquids will be converted into gases. And when we cool gases, this process is known as condensation. So when if liquids are applied heat, it will be converted into gases, and if we cool the gases will be converted into liquid. This process is known as condensation. If we apply heat to solid, solid will melt, and if we cool the liquids, it will solidify. Okay, what happens when clothes are wet? These molecules of water try to absorb the energy, get the sufficient amount of kinetic energy to get rid the intermolecular force of attraction and try to skip the surface. Okay, this process is known as evaporation. So this process is dependent on the amount of heat required, the area of exposure area. Okay, larger the exposure area, greater will be the evaporation. Okay, and if surrounding is wet, there will not be any transfer of energy. Okay, if heat is required for this evaporation process. So due to moisture, there will not be any transfer of energy. Hence, we can say that clothes will dry faster in summer than winter. So next question is, how can fish survive in frozen water? So we know that this is a lake. So these are the layers of water. At 4 degrees Celsius, water will be having maximum density. Means, if the temperature is 3 degrees Celsius, 4 degrees Celsius and 5 degrees Celsius, water will be heavier, and at 3 degree and 5 degree, either we increase or reduce, water will be lighter. And we know that two objects of having some density, D1 and D2. Okay, the object which is having lighter density will float on that object which is having greater density. Okay, that's why oil floats on the surface of water. So, ice will float at this surface. Okay, and if temperature is 4 degrees Celsius, here water will be the densest, and as we know that there will not be any transfer of energy or transfer of heat as the ice is heat insulator. That's why fish can survive in this water region, right? So based on the same concept, we can discuss now about the hydrological cycle. First of all, so what do we know about this monsoon or rain? We know that 71% of the earth's surface is made up of, is surrounded by water. And remaining portion is surrounded by a solid, right? Due to sun, solar rays are absorbed by water or sea and by ground. We know that ground absorbs more energy. Gets heated faster and slows down faster as compared with water. Okay. So as we go with the higher altitude, so temperature decreases. Here the temperature is high at ground level, at ground surface. At water surface, temperature is relatively low. And due to heating of the surface, here low pressure will be generated, and here high pressure will be generated. We know that energy always transferred from high potential to low potential. In this case, breeze will flow from water to ground. These are known as sea breeze. At daytime. In night time, the process will be reversed. Okay. After coming
here at high altitude, as the temperature is low, process of condensation takes place to form clouds. Here pressure will be high. As density is increased over here, okay, due to formation of clouds, pressure will be high over here, and relatively less pressure will be developed at the same altitude, but in case of water, okay. So there will be again breeze will flow from this direction to this direction, and again cold air will sink to get the original position. Cycle is completed. This is the basic of the rain or monsoon. Okay, these are the prerequisites of the hydrological cycle. So we know that suppose this is the ground surface, this is the rock. Here is the sea. So here is the sun. Here will be the evaporation. As we have explained the concept of evaporation at the start of the video, condensation will take place to form the clouds, and precipitation will occur over here. This means it is the rain. This is the rain. Okay. In various forms. Again, due to the surface, there will be the motion from the surface to the ground, which is known as infiltration. Ground water will flow. This is the ground water. There will be evaporation from the trees, leaves. These are known as transpiration. Okay. And the water will flow from the surface. It will be known as surface runoff. So, if you observe over here, there will be a transportation of moisture or water from the ground to atmosphere, or sea to atmosphere, and again from atmosphere to the sea. Okay. Here the cycle completes. This is known as hydrology. Okay, thank you very much.